sophomore. Number 20, senior Connor Martin. And number 23, senior Tyler Hall. Lexington Panthers is coached by head coach Brandon Carlson. Lexington is coached by Coach Ted Hall.
Good evening. Welcome to Lexington Christian Academy. Big matchup tonight. Got the Holy War between the home team, the Lexington Christian Academy Eagles, and the Lexington Catholic Knights. Lexington Catholic 13-1, LCA 10-2. Lexington Catholic started off with a loss on the road at North Laurel on a November 28th, but they've won their last 13 in a row. LCA on a winning streak themselves as they've won 4 in a row, and they just got done winning a tournament in Charleston, North Carolina, the Carolina Invitational. And we're ready to play and tip this one off. The Reese Carter and Tyler Hall. Catholic gets the tip. LCA starts out in a zone defense. Reinhardt up top. Turner, right to get it into Potter. He's the leading scorer on the year four. Lexington Catholic, jump is up, it's off. Right underneath, it looks like Potter was on the out-of-bounds line, so it will go over to the Eagles. LCA comes in, averaging 71 points a game. They are led by Anderson Green, their leading scorer on the year, averaging 14 points a game. Three ball in the corner, up, and it is good. Basket by Connor Martin, 6 foot senior, and LCA gets on top 3-0. Little token full court pressure there, but no problem for the Knights as they get that through. Reinhardt up top, looks the middle, elbow jumper up by Tyler Dahl, comes off Tyler Hall with the rebound for the Eagles. Eagles looking to run, Martin with another three ball, it's good, and LCA up 6-0. A little full court pressure by the Eagles, but no problem by the Knights getting past that. Potter down in the corner, fake three ball, then he goes back up, jumpers up. By Reinhardt, off, going to be out of bounds. Looks like it's going to go off the Knights and go over to LCA. But as you can tell, in the Holy War, we got a great crowd here tonight. Both student bodies got their sections filled. Glad that you joined us here. LCA 10-2, Lexington Catholic 13-1. Green gets it, try to trap him there, but he gets it out up. Up top to Hagan Preston, back to him. Cross court pass, three ball tips up by Saxton Howard. A little bit long though, Hall with the rebound, it's good. Tyler Hall wins the rebound, he's leading the Eagles in rebounds at 6 a game, also averaging 14 points. Potter with the elbow jumper, it's off. Rebound goes to Green for the Eagles. Preston almost lost it, got it up to Green. Trying to get it into Hall, but letting just a little too much. So first turnover of the game will go over to the Knights. 8-0, LCA on top. I'm Greg Horn, thanks for joining us here tonight. Brandon Salzman, outstanding coach, Lexington Catholic, and Ted Hall, the head coach for the Eagles. Potter with a nice take, but can't get it to fall. Green gets the rebound, kicks it out to Preston. Thought about it, Green with the three ball. It's up, a little bit long. Potter gets it, but can't hold it. Preston with the rebound, kicks it back out. Green up top, Hall with the three ball. It's a little bit long. Good hustle there by the Eagles. They come up with a loose ball. A little runner in the lane, and it's good by Saxton Howard. LCA up 10-0, and Brandon Southland says, we need to get a timeout and regroup here. Lexington Catholic just won the White Greer Maggard Classic, their own home tournament. Had five five of the top 10 teams in the state of Kentucky. And Lexington Catholic won that championship. And they beat number 5 Bowling Green and number 10 Lyon County. They played great defense during that tournament. They held Lyon County 28 points below average and Bowling Green 24 points below their average. And in the championship game against North Oldham, they held them 24 points below their average. So Lexington Catholic really hanging their hat on their defense. But so far, their offense has not gotten untracked yet. Let's see what adjustments they make out of the timeout. Try to break the press there, but on the turnover, the Eagles looking to run, but good transition defense by the Knights. Hall's got it up top. He drives in the lane, little elbow jumper, and the bank is open. It's good. Hall's got 4. LCA extends its lead to 12. 4:34 left here in the opening quarter. Steal by Hagan Preston. Eagles looking to run. Good job in transition D again by Lexington Catholic. And Paul got it, but he was pushed in the back. The foul's going to be on Lexington Catholic's Sam Clements. That's going to be his first and the team's first. Anderson Green up top. They're looking inside the Hall, but not able to get it in, but then they do get it. He steps back out, kicks it up top. Green thought about the 3 ball, drives it, spin in the lane, kicks it back out. Connor Martin trying to get the ball in the corner to Preston Hagan, but passes to Hagan Preston, I'm sorry. A little bit high, though, on the turnover to go to the Knights. Eagles' second turnover of the game. Steal, though, by Hagan Preston, makes up for it, gets it. Green with the drive and 1. Foul goes on the Knights. Tyler Dole, the 6'5 junior. He was the most valuable player of the White Greer Maggard Classic last week, but Green, that gives him his first 2 points of the game. His free throw's up. It's good. Green on the year was the leading scorer for LCA at 14 points a game. Makes it 15-0 Eagles. Knight trying to see if they can get something, but still just not able to get in any offensive rhythm yet. On the turnover, LCA will get it back. So Brandon Salzman calls in John Reinhardt to go back in the game. He started the game, but got a little quick breather after that timeout. He's going to come back up. Reinhardt, one of their leaders, 6-foot junior. Preston's got it up top for the Eagles. Kicks it over to Green in the corner. Howard back up top. Howard thought about the 3 ball, but kicks it back up. Green with the drive, but kicks it out. Howard wide open for the 3. It's good. Saxton Howard with the 3 ball. That gives him 5, and Eagles extend their lead to 18. A little pressure, a deflection there. Good job by Preston, but Eagles get, Knights get it back. A little runner in the lane, but won't go. Shot by Rowan Williams. Couldn't get it to fall, though, and Eagles looking to run. Hagan Preston called for steps, got in the lane, dragged his pivot foot. Checking in for Lexington Catholic. Hudson Parks. Also, Tyler Dole checks back in the game. Sparks, their second leading scorer on the year, averaging 13 points and 5 rebounds. An outstanding 3-point shooter for Lexington Catholic, making 40% of his attempts. He has the most attempts on the year for Lexington Catholic with 76 3-point attempts. Potter with it. He's committed to Miami of Ohio. Gets it. Strong move in the post. Gets the shot up, but Hall is going to be called for the foul. And Potter will go to the free throw line 4-2. On the year from the free throw line, Potter's been 50 times. He's made 38 of those for 76%. And he gets Lexington Catholic on the board. was fighting a little bit of an illness back in December, but seems to be getting his strength back. Second one, I thought that was good, but it comes out, and Eagles get the rebound. Green's got it. Good pressure. He turns it over, and the basket is good by Lexington Catholics. Hubs and Sparks. But Sparks with some full court pressure is going to be called for the foul. It's going to be his first foul. Be the team's third. LCA with their first substitution of the game. Braden Virus, the 6 foot junior, will check in. And Hagan Preston, the sophomore, will get a breather. Howard brings it up for the Eagles. Met there by Doyle. Tyler Hall's got it. Great pressure defense by Doyle. Gets it over to Green. Green sets the offense back up on top. Hall gets in the corner, thought about a three ball. Good defensive pressure by Lexington Catholic. We're talking about what a great job they did in the White Greer Magger class. Good job there by, I believe it's Doyle. Good hustle, knocks the ball off. Couldn't pick it back up. A great hustle there by Tyler Doyle, 6'5 junior for Lexington Catholic. Goes back to LCA, but tremendous pressure by Doyle, who was the MVP of the White Bear Magger Classic last week. Howard checks back in for the Eagles. He's got it up top. Kicks in the corner, three balls up, and it's good by Colton Cummins. Cummins, a sophomore, gets his first points of the game, and the Eagles get their lead back up to 18, their largest lead of the game, but three ball is up, and it's good by John Reinhardt. Almost over and back there, but good job by Myers to get it. Trap in the corner there. Good job by Lexington Catholic. And Hall just has to throw it off the leg of Lexington Catholic. Coach Hall, Ted Hall, calls out the play. Howard's got it. Trying to get it to Howard. Was looking to Hall, but not there. So back up top, Saxton Howard. Myers has got it. Up top to Hall. Howard looks. Gives it over to Hall. 45 seconds left in the first quarter. Backs it out. Guarded by Doyle. Howard with the drive. Kick in the corner. Three balls up. A little bit long. Rebound goes to the Knights. Knights looking to run. Reinhardt kicks it up in the corner. Almost went out of bounds. Good save by Spark. The drive, and it's good. Nice drive. Bucket by Rowan Williams. Good deflection by the Knights. Great hustle. The loose ball goes, and it's up and good by Cummins. Great hustle by both teams. Cummins able to come up with a loose ball, and he gets the bucket. And that'll end your first quarter. Great hustle play there by Braden Myers, the 6 foot junior, and the home team crowd appreciates the effort by the Eagles. That's going to be the end of our first quarter. We'll take a short break. Your score at the end of one. Lexington Christian Academy, 23. The visitors for Lexington Catholic, 8. Welcome back to Lexington Christian Academy High School basketball. We had a little bit of technical challenges, but we'll get those corrected at halftime. We appreciate your patience. Big City matchup here in the Holy War. Lexington Christian Academy hosting Lexington Catholic. The Eagles came out on fire, but know the Catholic will try to respond here in the second quarter, winning 13 games in a row. Reinhardt with the three ball, rims in and out. Nice tip by Potter. Wow. 7-footer with a nice rebound tip, and the officials are really letting the play. It's a physical game, and they're letting the play both ways. So good defense there, and the steal and the bucket by Rowan Williams. And Lexington Catholic cuts it down to 11. And there'll be a foul called there on Williams. That'll be the team's fourth, be his first. Both teams been playing full court pressure. And the Lexington Catholic would like to get you into an up-tempo game. They have a lot of depth. They play very tenacious defense. And this time Green gets it, kicks in the corner to Cummins, back up top to Green. Green drives. Kicks it out in the corner. Back up top. Myers. Now Saxon Howard says, let's settle it down. Coach Ted Hall calls the play out to his point guard, Howard, and Eagles get it set up. Over to Hagan Preston. Preston with the drive and loses it. Gets it back up. Howard, three ball in the corner. Rims out. Hagan Preston's going to be called on the block out. Call for the push on the turnover. It'll go over to Lexington Catholic. Hope Cummins will get a breather. LCA picks up full court, but Knights no pressure with it. Gets it in. Three ball in the corner. Comes out. Rebounded by Green. Tries to get it to Preston, but good pressure by the Knights. They get the steal. The layup, it's good. Reinhardt gets his first, or he's got 5 points now. First two, he had a three ball in the first quarter. Kick in the corner, three ball by Hall. It's good. The Knights respond. Headed down to 9, but Hall gets back up to 11. Good drive there by the Knights, but unable to finish. Nice pass, Hall with the little baseline jumper, but can't get it to fall. Rebound goes over to the Knights, Doyle. Three ball in the corner, up. It's off by Clements. LCA, Myris with the rebound. Good pass up court. Hall ran the floor and got behind the defense. And good pass and assist. LCA lead back up to 14. Potter with the three ball. Oh, rims out. Rebound goes to Green. Potter shoots 40, makes 42% of his three-point shots. The seven-footer's got a nice touch. 11 of 26 on the year. 42% from three-point range. Green with the drive, kicks it in the corner. Three ball by Hayes. Preston's up, but can't get it to fall. Doyle with the rebound for the Knights. LCA still playing zone defense. Reinhardt thought about the three ball. Doyle's got it. He faked it and put it on the floor, but good job by Hagan Preston stopping his drive. Good pass in the middle of the lane there. Jump shot's up by Brody Turner, but can't get it to fall, and Eagles will bring it up with Hagan Preston. LCA averaging 71 points a game this year, giving up 59 points on defense. Lexington Catholic averaging 68 points a game. They're only giving up 52 points on defense. Hall with the three ball, short, but Green gets the rebound for the Eagles. Pulls up, oh, nice pass underneath the Hall, but the seven-footer Potter alters that shot. He kicks it out to Howard. Howard, three balls long. Great pass in the court, way to run the court, but Unfortunately, Turner could not get it to fall, but the rebound, the follow-up by Clements. Makes it 28-16. That's Clements' first deuce of the game. Clements has got two for Lexington Catholic. John Reinhardt's got five. Reese Potter's got three. LCA. Colt Cummins has five. Anderson Green has three. Saxton Howard has five to lead the Eagles. LCA fresh off winning their own tournament and went to Charleston, South Carolina for the Carolina Invitational Tournament. They defeated teams from South Carolina, Florida, and Tennessee. Anderson Green was named the MVP of the tournament. The Eagles had four players at least in double figures every game and got six players averaging 8 points or more on the team. So really well-balanced scoring by LCA. And the three ball's up, and it was good. Made by Braden Myers, a six-foot junior, his first points of the game. Eagles up by 15. Side out of bounds on the turnover. It's going to go over to the Eagles. Student section at LCA loves it. Lexington Catholic's got their student section filled too. And Saxton Howard brings it up. Catholic waiting with the 2-2-1. Unfortunately, Green not focused. Turned the ball over. Nice looking to run, and charge is going to be called. I believe it's going to be on Reinhardt. Apologize, that's Rowan Williams, 21, not 22. So we go on Williams. Unfortunately, that's going to be his second foul. So the engine is it. Continue to keep him in. But very physical game. The officials are letting the play. Both teams like to bring pressure. Ball gets inbound to the Eagles. Hall's got it. Kicks it over. Connor Martin up to Green. Green gets it to Myers, kicks it to Hall. Hall thought about another three ball. He's already made a couple of those, but Coach Ted Hall says, let's bring it out. It's working a little bit of clock. Eagles up by 15, 2:51 left till halftime. Lexington Catholic's won 13 games in a row. LCA's won four in a row. Hall trying to get his third three, and he does. Hall's got 12 to lead all scores. But Lexington Catholic tries to respond, three balls off. Hall gets the rebound, hands it off to Howard. He gets bumped, no call. Gets it up to Myers in the corner. Green drives, kicks it. Hall with the drive up, but can't get it to fall. Rebound goes to Knights. Knights looking to run. Doyle's got it, kicks it. The drive, little runner in the lane by Williams, so can't get it to fall. Doyle with a three ball, it's good for Lexington Catholic. Doyle gets his first points of the game, and Eagles lead cut down to 15 on that. 2 minutes left here until halftime, but LCA turns it over. Subs into the game. Potter checks back in for Lexington Catholic. Hagan Preston and Saxton Howard back in for the Eagles. Eagles look to pick up full court. Doyle's got it. Kicks it over to Turner. Back to Turner. Doyle's got it. Doyle three ball, top of the key. It's good. Turner Doyle with his second three of the game. Lead down to 12 for the LCA. Dodo on the year. Nate, that's his 11th three of the year. Howard looks at Green, can't get it to him. Drive, runner in the lane, but Cummins can't get it to finish. Howard gets the loose ball. A little runner in the lane. It's good. Saxton Howard with his 7th point of the game, but nice pushing the ball up the court, and Potter with a flush. Nice offensive transition by the Knights after the Eagles scored. Man, you can't turn your head for a moment. The Eagles respond with a three ball as Martin buries the three. LCA back up by 14. Looks like Howard's going to be called for the foul. But Connor Martin buried the three after Potter got the dunk. So LCA averaging 71 points on the year. They've already got 39, and we've still got 35 seconds left here in the first half. Lexington Catholic with 25 points. They're averaging 68 points. So they're a little bit below their average on pace at this point, but still a whole second half of basketball to come. But still got 30 seconds left here in the first half. Doyle's got it, kicks it over in the corner. Three ball is up, and it's off by Hudson Sparks. Howard's got it for LCA. Guarded by Doyle. Hall comes up, gives him the screen. Howard crossover, pull up, three ball, top of the key. It's good. Saxton Howard is feeling it right now. He's got 10 points. Hall's got 12, and three at the buzzer by Catholic is off. And LCA leads at halftime 42-25. We'll take a short break, and we're going to work on some technical situation, and we'll be back for your second half action in about 10 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now for your halftime entertainment, the LCA Bids Team. Thank you.
contests. Test, test, test. Test 1, 2, 3. I hear myself in this one, but I don't hear it in this one. You know what I need to do over here? Eyes up.
Check, check one, check two.
Got me?
Check, check.
Yeah, I got you,
okay.
Too.
You hear me?
Yep.
Okay. Yep, we're good.
Test, 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 tests. All right.
Cool.
We're good now, man.
Good.
Look forward. Hey, if you guys can hear us back at home, you're still watching at halftime here, send me a text. If you got my number, send me a text or just tweet at me and tell me you guys can hear me. I'm trying to work on a couple little technical issues here at LCA. I knocked all of Greg's papers over. That's about the extent of them.
I need all the help I can get, so no worries there. But we'll look at some halftime statistics here. LCA up at halftime, 4:37 left till the second half starts. LCA with the lead 42-24. Let's look first for Lexington Catholic. Sam Clements had 2. Tyler Doyle had 6. Reese Potter had 5. John Reinhardt had 5. Rowan Williams had 6 for the Knights. For LCA, Colt Cummins had 5, Anderson Green 6, Saxton Howard had 10, Tyler Hall led all scorers with 12, Connor Martin had 6, and Braden Myers had 3 for LCA's 42 points. LCA had 19 rebounds, Lexington Catholic had 8. Shooting-wise, for the game in the first half, Lexington Catholic shot 38.5% from the field. LCA a blistering 59%. Three-point range, Lexington Catholic shot 27%. LCA another blistering shooting percentage of 53%. LCA from the free throw line, 1 for 1. Lexington Catholic 1 for 2. So they really were letting both teams play. So I have to give the officials credit. They were letting them both play. It was a physical game, but they were consistent on both ends. So that is all you can ask for. And so neither team got to the free throw line very much. Points off turnovers were very even. LCA had 11, Lexington Catholic had 12. Points in the paint, LCA had 12. The Knights had 14. The largest lead of the game was by LCA. They had 18. The largest lead was at 18 off the bench. LCA had 14 points, Lexington Catholic had 8. And that is your halftime statistics. Your halftime score, LCA 42, Lexington Catholic 24. Both teams come in with winning streaks. LCA had won 4 in a row. They had went down to Charleston, South Carolina, and won the Carolina Invitational. And then Lexington Catholic, I know you saw a lot of those games, Aunt, William, at the yep. White Rear Maggard Classic. Just a very, very impressive showing by Lexington Catholic. Share a little bit about that. I know you got to see a lot of those games.
Yeah, you know, they had some tough competition, and I kind of wonder if that's playing into it tonight, other than, you know, LCA pretty much perfect from the field out there. And they're hitting the threes like it wasn't nothing, you know, in that first half as I was watching next to you over there. But, you know, I just wonder if Lexington Catholic might be a little tired off of that, or, you know, LCA certainly has got a great game plan coming in here, and it's just shooting the lights out of the ball right now. So it's not the characteristic of, you know, Lexington Catholic tonight to play the way that they have so far.
There's no doubt about it. Lexington Catholic shooting, making 49% of their shots on the year, only 29% in the first half, so we definitely expect that to change. I would expect Reese Potter, the Miami of Ohio commit, averaging 19 a game. I would say they'll probably try to go inside to him a lot because, wow, what an impressive player he is.
Yeah, him or Doyle, and then, of course, Sparks, you know, would give him a little lift as well if he can start getting some shots down. But I'm totally impressed and in awe right now because nobody's done what LCA's done in that first half against Lexington Catholic all season.
Well, there's no doubt LCA is clicking on all cylinders right now. They're shooting over 50% from three-point range, 52% here in the first half, and that is the great equalizer. LCA with not a lot of size, but play really hard. They play together, and so far that combination's working, but we expect a great second half. We're glad you're with us, and thanks for your patience with us. Well, we got some technical challenges worked out, but we're looking forward to a big second half between two outstanding teams. Lexington Catholic ranks second in the state, 13-1. LCA, 10-2. So both teams really playing well this year.
Yeah, Lexington Catholic, their only loss of the season was to North Laurel. And that was the very first game. They went down to North Laurel and played Reed Shepherd and his crew. And, you know, a lot of people say, hey, it's Reed Shepherd down there. But he's got two other big teammates that are on that team that are fantastic. You know, so they're a really good, well-put-together team. But I, like I said, I'm in awe, Greg. I mean, nobody's done to Lexington Catholic what LCA's done in that first half.
I'll tell you, Ryan Davidson with North Laurel, I've seen him play a couple times. He is very, very impressive. But Catholics won 13 in a row since that game, and I'm sure they are going to come out and give it all they've got this half in the holy war here. So see what happens. Doyle's got it for Lexington Catholic, and they try to look inside the Potters expected there, as William and I talked. But looks kind of tough start there for Lexington Catholic. They get the turnover, but they pick up with the full court pressure, and they do bring the heat. LCA's Hagan Preston brings it up, gets in the corner though, but unfortunately pass a little bit low to Connor Martin, so the Eagles turn it over. So both teams on their first possession with turnovers.
Yeah, not a good way to start the second half for either team, but you know, if Catholic can if Catholic can get in their game, they'll be okay. If LCA continues to shoot the lights out, you know, this is going to be a bad night tonight for the Knights.
Doyle got up top. Potter, you know, he's 7 foot, makes 42% of his threes and gets a jump shot. Can't get it, but the rebound to the Knights goes up. And can't see the number there. Is that Sparks, William? I can't tell.
That looked like that was Doyle.
That's Doyle, yep.
Yeah, Doyle got the rebound and went down hard on the putback attempt.
Tyler Doyle was the MVP of the White Greer Magger Classic last week.
Yeah, and he makes such a big difference for the team. You know, you talk about key role players, you know, Myers and Howard for LCA. They certainly step up the game for their team along with Hall and, you know, some of those guys. But Doyle's really made a big difference coming over from Woodford County for Lexington Catholic.
Well, he is an 80% free throw shooter. You can see why. He makes both of those, and that gives Doyle 8. Leads down to 16 for the Eagles, and on the steal, our Eagles score there, and that is Sparks right there. Hudson Sparks, 6'5 senior, who just received an offer from Brescia College recently. Mm-hmm. This time, LCA breaks the press. Three ball up top, Preston thought about, kicks it to Hall in the corner, baseline jumper, it's good. And that gives Hall 14. He leads all scores.
Yeah, he's got a nice square, you know, when he's looking at the basket, squared up nice.
LCA gets a steal there with some full court pressure, and Howard dishes behind the back, but the Knight defender tried to take the charge, and he was called for the block on that. That foul's going to be on Reinhardt. That's going to be his second. LCA will have it underneath, out of bounds. Preston trying to get in, finally looks up, gets it into Martin. Anderson Green's got it. Back up to Green after Hall had it there for a moment.
That's the other thing LCA's done that's been pretty impressive in that first half was, you know, Catholics got the length on them. But, and Catholics got the length on most teams. They're just a big, tall team. But LCA was playing with them above the rim.
Hall, a little jump shot there, but can't get it to fall. Sparks gets the rebound, tries to kick it out on the side to Doyle, but good defense there by Hagan Preston. He kicks the ball, and this 5'10 sophomore, so it'll stay Knight's ball, but stops a fast break opportunity there. The Knights trying to get some transition, some easy buckets so they can get back in this game, but LCA likes to bring a little bit of pressure themselves. Sparks with the drive, good pass to Potter, and Potter with the finish. And
he got cracked on the ear, it looked like, on the way down.
Yep, he's shake it off. That had to sting a little bit, so they do call the foul then. For the first to know they're going to call, but they get Preston on that, so it's going to be his second foul, and Potter's going to go to the free throw line. Potter's got 7 points on the night for the Knights, and at the free throw line on the year, Potter, 76% free throw shooter.
That's not bad for a big guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's not bad at all.
Well, very impressive part. He shoots 42% from three-point range. Miami of Ohio has got themselves a nice player.
Yeah, what's so scary about Potter is he's not 100% yet. He was running through, you know, some back spasms, those kind of things. And he's not playing 100% just yet.
Well, definitely the sky's the limit for that young man. So good pressure there by the Knights. So LCA is going to keep it, though. And 44-31, LCA leading, 5:57 left here in the third quarter. And Greg Horn alongside me, William Warfield, thanks for joining us for the Holy War. Lexington Christian Academy hosting the Knights of Lexington Catholic.
Hey, so, yeah, sorry I crashed your party tonight, but I wanted to make sure I was here for this game.
I always like to hang out with you, my man. I'm glad to have you.
I see you've been staying busy.
Yes, sir. Howard gets it, kicks it, Hall, three ball, good. Potter came and extended, put a little pressure there on Hall, and that's a big frame to shoot the ball over. Catholic responds in transition. Doyle with the three ball and cuts the lead down to 11. Hall's got it, gets over to Preston. Got to be careful in those traps. He does a great job getting the pass over court in the corner to Green, but he's not going to be able to hold on to it, so that's what Lexington Catholic wants. Wants to get some pressure, and Coach Ted Hall calls timeout. That's what Lexington Catholic loves to do. Their defense, they held in the White River Magnet Classic last week when they won that tournament, beating number 5 Bowling Green and number 10 Lyon County. They held Lyon County 28 points below their average and Bowling Green 24 points below their average.
Yeah, that game against Lyon County, that was the perfect game that they played. That was a shocker because Lyon County is really, really good. You know, of course, the Perry kid is second all-time in scoring now in the state of Kentucky, and he's chasing number 1, King Kelly Coleman, which is pretty impressive. They actually play Lyon County North Laurel plays Saturday over at Catholic.
Really?
So, yeah, and we'll have that game on the network, but shameless plug there. But anyway, Lyon County's the real deal, man.
I talked to some friends of mine that went and saw Lyon County play, and they loved it, man. Loved watching those guys play. So,
And I saw, you know, LCA went down and did really well in their tournament over the holiday.
They did. Went down to Charleston, South Carolina, won the Carolina Invitational, beating teams from South Carolina, Florida, and Tennessee.
Yeah, that's big time.
Well, let's see how Lexington Catholic's trying to get this lead under double figures. Be the first time in a long time that it'll be down to single digits. See what Coach Salzman draws up. Ted Hall called timeout, kind of get his guys settled down after some turnovers there, but
I got a few shout-outs to give, if you don't care, in a second.
Absolutely.
I can wait till our next dead ball.
All right, Doyle gets it, kicks it out. Sparks drives, hits baseline. Potter with the third dunk of the game.
That's almost textbook for that young man now. Is he gets open underneath there. You give him an inch, he's putting it in there.
Great pass by Sparks to Potter. LCA, good pressure breaking. Ted Hall with the nice finish.
Very nice.
Gives Hall 16, the senior, having an outstanding year. And Center College and Asbury, we're taking a look at this young man. He's very, very talented.
I love the speed burst that, you know, Hall's kind of got three gears that he goes in. And that last one was about as fast as he goes. You saw that speed burst to get there just a little bit quicker than Potter got to the rim.
Well, Brody Turner was providing some great defensive pressure, but reached in a little too much there on Preston. Gets called for the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, Brody Turner is kind of like Preston. You know, it's one of those guys that does things that you're not going to see on the stat sheet. But, you know, to be a complete team, you need a player like that. And certainly both of those guys fill their role very well. I heard the Green kid's going to be a star, Greg.
Yeah, he won MVP at that tournament. And he's having a nice year. He leads LCA, scoring 14 points a game. And LCA increases their lead back up to 13. Nice pass. Wow. Great find there in the finish by Rowan Williams. And gives him four, and lead goes back down to 11 points.
That's about as close as they've had it all night is 11 points. That's as close as it's been. Because, I mean, LCA got out to an 18-0 lead before Catholic scored their first three. So
you had some shout-outs you wanted to give?
I do. Some of them are sponsors. Some of them are people watching back at home. But the Benningtons are watching. They're watching tonight. And also want to give a shout-out to, obviously, you know, Kentucky Orthodontics and Invisalign over there. Or, excuse me, Weiger and Maggard and Kentucky Ortho. How about that? As a brain freeze there. But anyway, want to give a shout-out to them. You know, UK Sports Medicine for all they do for us. And Mingy Beef Jerky, of course, and Clark's Bump and Shop. And yeah, so appreciate you guys.
All right, lots of great places there.
I was thinking about Dr. D there for a second. Left us a little too soon.
Doyle with a nice steal for Lexington Catholic, but he is going to be called for the charge. So that full court pressure, one of the things when you're like the full court pressure, you're hoping that fatigue will settle in on the team you're pressing. And LCA struggled a lot more here in this third quarter than they did in the first half. So one of the ways Catholic likes to get into those games is how they got all those wins last week. But Howard this time responds. Saxton Howard for the Eagles, the sophomore. That's got 12 for him, and LCA's lead back up to 13.
Saxton Howard's dad, too, you know, Howard Real Estate, they're one of our partner sponsors on the network, too. We appreciate all they do.
Doyle there with a nice little runner in the lane. That gives him 12. And back down to 11. LCA breaks the press this time. Howard's got it. Three ball in the corner. I think that's Myris. And it's good. No, I apologize. That was actually Martin. Connor Martin.
Connor landed in the front row over there when he released that thing.
Yes, sir. And Connor
Fade
Martin.
Back three.
He's balling tonight. 14 for him. LCA kind of trading buckets right now, so sure Catholic like trying to get around 10, 9 points maybe before the fourth quarter, and they do respond there with a nice three ball there by Reinhardt. So Reinhardt's got 8. LCA trying to see if they can respond. Green with a three ball in the corner. It's going to be long, and rebound goes to the Knights. Knights looking to run. Nice crossover and the drive. Not able to get it to fall by Clements, but great rebound. Very athletic young man. Wow. Hall getting pressure. Got the trap in the corner and tries to throw it off to Doyle, but Doyle does a good job turning and being able to keep the ball from going out of bounds. And Catholic with another turnover. So LCA, the pressure, Lexington Catholic's tightened up this half, and some turnovers have resulted. See if Catholic can capitalize. Little runner in the lane. It's short, but the rebound put back. That bucket's going to be good for Miller Williams. So Williams gets his first two of the game. And Williams got it right now, pressing down. Reinhardt, three ball. It's going to be off. Hall with the rebound. And Lee Miller can be called for over the back.
Wow.
Well, it They are letting them play tonight, and it is fun. That will be on Miller, his first foul. Going to be the team's fourth.
I wonder what the, you know, how it's been, you know, when the football team wins and how the basketball team's doing the same season, because it was flipped this year. And you see, you know, LCA obviously up in this one right now.
Yeah, that's a great question.
I wonder how that's played out over the years. I'm gonna have to look that up and research it.
Good question. Green's got it up top for LCA.
Because it's been since the Kyle Rode team, right? Since LCA's really, you know,
had a dominant team.
Team over Catholic, you know.
Wow, that good drive there by, with the block by Potter, and then the response by Catholic Reinhardt there with the bucket. It gives him eight, gets it down to nine, 33 seconds left in the quarter. It's the lowest it's been. It got down to single digits about 3 minutes ago for just about 10 seconds, and then LCA responded. So,
yeah, I mean, if you're Lexington Catholic, you're going back to the, you know, bench, you know, when we get to the in between the quarters here, you're going to go back and you're going to be like, man, we took their best blow to start the game, and we're still here.
Well, it's down to 7 points there with Catholic trying to see if they can get it down to five or maybe four with a three ball. So 18 seconds left here in the third quarter.
If you're LCA, of course, coming out, you got to come out swinging, right?
No doubt. Potter with a little runner, and it's good there. It's good, and he's going to be fouled. I believe they're going to call that on Colt Cummins. They call it on Preston, so that's going to be Preston's third, and Potter's now got 12. He's leading Lexington Catholic in scoring in this game. We'll see if he can get 13. He does, and it's down to five, so closest it's been the whole game for Lexington Catholic. We've got 7.2 seconds left.
I'm going to give one more shout-out real quick. Ken's Auto over there in Paris, and then Ronnie Perry, of course, who runs it over there. And his daughter, Camden, turned 15, so happy birthday to Camden. She's a knight as well.
Three ball up by Green, but can't get it to fall. And we knew that this would be a war in the Holy War, if they affectionately call it. And we knew that 18-point lead, and the Catholic would make a run, and they did, and we're down to four, so we've got ourselves a game.
It's a good one, man. We started off lopsided, but, you know, these two teams, I mean, they're probably, I mean, if you look at the district, the way that the district is right now, I haven't seen Dunbar yet, but I know Tate's Creek is down. I know Lafayette certainly down. So, really, I mean, it's on this side of town, right?
Yep. LCA's got a lot of young kids. Hall's the only senior on this team, but they're playing together as a team. And got four guys averaging double figures, so they don't just depend on one guy. In fact, they've got six averaging 8 points or more. So, it's a good team effort and playing with a lot of confidence.
Yep.
What a fourth quarter. Glad you tuned in with us. I'm Greg Horn. Alongside me is the King of Stream, William Moorfield. So, got a great matchup here tonight. Glad that you're with us. LCAX started off 18-0 in the first quarter.
I was going to talk to you, too. Your travels, you know, going over. You went overseas, right?
Went over to Israel. Got to hang out for 10 days.
Man, that was awesome.
Yes, very fortunate to do that. Speaking of the Holy War, got to go to the Holy Land. So
that's awesome. That's a big milestone, lifetime trip right there.
Yeah, feel very, very fortunate to get to do that. So thankful. All right, LCA's got the ball to start the fourth quarter here, and Braden Myers had it, hands it back off. He's got it, being pressured. Gets it out to Preston. And shout out to Crystal Foster watching the game. Her son Hunter, an outstanding football player for Lexington Catholic, got several college opportunities. Shot missed by Hall. Knights with the rebound. Doyle gets it. thinks about the three ball, kicks it out. Sparks got it. He thought about it, but Doyle says, I'll take it. And he buries it. And Doyle, he's struggling the first half, but man, he has found it here in the second half. And lead down to one, but the LCA's Howard shoots a three ball, but not able to get find the mark, and Sparks with the rebound.
And it is hard to believe it's down to one.
Potter gets a rebound, can't get the chippy to fall. It's going to go off LCA out of bounds. So Lexington Catholic look to see if they can take their first lead of the game.
I see Terry Johnson working hard down there on the sidelines. And, you know, also Dave Nuremberg, who's certainly works really hard over there at Lexington Catholic. You got two great ADs with these programs.
Yeah, both schools blessed with outstanding athletic directors. Potter's got it on the elbow, tries to back in, a little spinner in the lane, can't get it to finish. Fight for the rebound, but the Eagles come out with it. Hagan Preston brings it up for the Eagles, gets it to Hall, three balls up. Can't get that one to go and tip back out. Hall gets his own rebound. Coach Hall, Ted Hall for the Eagles says, let's pull it back out, set it up, get a good shot this possession. Hagan Preston up top. He's being guarded closely by Sparks.
The Catholics in that zone right now, and LCA looked like they were running a box one on defense. Did that look like that to you as well?
Well, I know obviously with Potter, you're trying to keep him from getting there. You got to pressure. Hall gets a turnaround. It's good. So that's what you got to get. Your senior responding when the game gets tight. And
yeah.
Mr. Tyler Hall responds. Hall leading the Eagles 16 points.
LCA's in a 3-2 right now as well.
Three ball in the corner. A little bit long, but Sparks with the rebound. Kicks it out. Reinhardt three ball. He can't get it to fall. Hall with another rebound, but Catholic swarms him, but they're going to be a reach-in foul called. And
that's what that zone does, is it opens up those threes. You know, they're playing the zone, obviously, because of the big fella down low, but it does open up those threes. If you're a good shooting team, it could cause that zone some problems.
That foul is going to be called on Williams. That's his second, team's fifth. Apologize, Hall's got 18. I said he had 16, but they had not added the other two yet. So Hall leading all scorers with 18. The drive, not able to get it finished. Preston, but late whistle there, but they do get the call. The call is going to be on Williams. That's going to be his third. Going to the free throw line for LCA will be Preston Hayes. And Hayes from the free throw line has been there 49 times. He's making 63% of those free throws. He makes the first one. That's actually his first point of the game. And he is actually the fourth leading scorer for the Eagles, almost 11 points a game. So been impressive that LCA's been able to do as well as they have with him just getting on the scoreboard, but he's handled the ball a lot, done a good job trying to handle this Knights pressure. Doyle's got it. A little token pressure there by LCA. They fall back into that 2-3. Get the ball right in the middle of the zone, which is what you want to do, but Williams could not get the little jumper to fall right in there. And say it's going off Lexington Catholic. Their crowd obviously doesn't like the call. We got a packed house here tonight. Great atmosphere for high school basketball. Checking in for Lexington Catholic is Sam Clements. Full court pressure. Reinhardt and Clements waiting to pick him up. They get it into Myris, and he kicks it over to Preston.
Yeah, this is that one game where, you know, if you had any part to do with the program at all, or if you had a family member in the program, you usually come out to watch this particular game. It's kind of like their Super Bowl every year.
Oh, yeah, that always brings it out. No matter what the records are, you throw those out. We got a great one tonight.
Well, you see it in other communities, too, East and West Jasmine, for example, or, you know, Danville and Boyle, or, you know, there's a whole bunch of them, North Laurel, South Laurel, just to name a few.
Absolutely. Maybe a five-second call there on LCA, so.
But this rivalry here is truly special.
Yeah, it is definitely an intense one, and a lot of kids know each other. LCA is going to be called for the foul this time. That one's going to be on Myrus. It's his first foul, LCA's fourth.
You know, if LCA, if they get a few more students in the building, you know, you guys will be playing in 3A football with Catholic soon, you know. Next time they reevaluate that, perhaps.
It is growing, and Potter tries to go baseline there, but Hall is going to be called for the foul, and so.
Catholic moving down to 3A. They were in 4A, but now they're, this next season, they'll be moving down to 3A.
Foul going to be called on LCA. That foul's going to be called on Hall. That's three on him, so 3:54 left. Hall's definitely a guy. He's the tallest player. He's their lone senior. So LCA definitely wants to keep him on the floor. 57-52, LCA leading by five. 3:54 left in the game. I'm Greg Horn alongside me, William Warfield. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Lexington Catholics won 13 in a row. LCA's won four in a row, so both teams want to keep those winning streaks going. So Doyle's going to inbound at four of the Knights. Let's see, with Potter be interesting, I would think they'll try to get in him somewhere inside there to penetrate the runner by Reinhardt. He can't get it. Fight underneath four. Great hustle. Lead by Reinhardt, but I believe he may have stepped out of bounds, but excellent hustle there by John Reinhardt, the 6 foot junior for Lexington Catholic. Green's telling his guys for LCA, hey, help me out guys, because it's gonna be full court pressure. So Hall comes back and Preston gets in the corner there, and they get a good job running the press offense this time. And pass a little bit behind Myrus, and it's physical, and this time foul will be called. So they call a little bit tighter here in the second half. And maybe it's going to be on Potter. That's his first. And
Myers so quick over there to the basketball. It's no wonder that he takes a lot of hits of just people running into him. He's so quick to it.
Yeah, he's a nice player.
And LCA, of course, Catholic in the bonus. LCA still got one more to go.
First one is up, and it is good. Gives him 4 points on the game.
Looks like both teams got three timeouts apiece.
Definitely could be using those, I got a feeling. Second one's good by Braden Myers. Gives him five, and LCA gets their lead back up to seven. No problem breaking the press there. Potter's got it, puts on the floor, which is amazing for a seven-footer. Nice little runner in the lane by Reese Potter. I guess Potter 15.
The story behind Potter was he originally came to Catholic and he's gonna be, you know, a guard. he wasn't that tall. And he had this growth spurt, he just didn't stop growing.
He's 7 foot now, going to be playing Miami of Ohio next year, but big three ball there by Myrus, and gives LCA a 8 point lead, and I believe Potter's going to score again. Unfortunately, I believe Hall's going to be called for his four, so that's a big one right there. LCA definitely wants Hall on the floor. He's leading them in scoring with 18.
Can you imagine Potter with some weight on his bones? Mm. And when he goes to college, they'll do that for him.
Absolutely.
I mean, he'll be eating five cheeseburgers a day just to make sure he gets the little weight on him. But yeah, he may do that now. But
Yeah, I'm really impressed. First time I've seen him in person this year, and very agile for his size. He puts the ball on the floor and then has a great stroke, 42% from three-point range.
They said literally between eighth and ninth grade, this guy grew a foot.
It's amazing that he's kept his agility, because very impressive. This time with the lead down to five, Potter does a great job with the free throw. LCA handles the press nice. Nice drive by Green, and he gets it in. Green, the leading scorer. That's only his fifth point, but that's a big bucket that they needed there. So we're going to have a timeout here. I believe Ted Hall called that one. His guys wants to get everybody grouped in here, see if they can be focused here for this last part. Right now, Ted Hall leading the way for LCA with 18 points, leading all scores.
Rhonda Deckett watching tonight from Nebraska. She says, go Eagles. Scott Baber, Ron Meyer, and Josh Bowman also watching tonight. And let's see here. There's a ton of people tuning into this one, as we expected. Do want to give a shout-out to Lexington Diagnostic Center, too. They're another one of our sponsors on the network. So thank you guys for all you do for us as well.
Reese Potter leading the way for Lexington Catholic with 18. Also LCA, Connor Martin's got 14. Braden Myers has got 8. Anderson Green, 5. And Hagan Preston's got 2 for the Eagles. For the Knights, Connor Doyle's got 15. Reinhardt's got 10. And Sparks has got 4. Those are the starters in right now for both teams. Get to Potter there, that elbow jump shot. That's like a layup for him, man.
Yeah.
He can't contest it. It's 7 foot. He does a great job keeping it above his head. And got a good stroke, and he's got 20 now.
Let me give a shout-out to BSN right here in Kentucky. You know, LCA is a BSN school, and they do the apparel for the teams and everything. And we're happy to have them on board with us too, Greg. And I know I sound like one of those infomercials or something, you know, where
yeah,
we get all the
sponsors. Yeah, you got to take care of the people that make this possible, man. So
exactly. So
you got to take care of them. We appreciate them.
And the radio station that you do on Friday nights. And
yeah, absolutely.
Do you do any basketball on that or no?
We haven't done basketball this year. We may do it again sometime, just doing the online this year. But, yeah, we appreciate all those sponsors with football, because, you know, we can't do that without them.
That's right.
Appreciate their partnership, man. So that's one thing I think it's great about our community. A lot of people like to help invest in high school athletics.
Yeah, especially with these two schools. You know, you got passion unlike any other with these two schools here. And, you know, it's a love-hate relationship between the two, as you know. You know, these rivalries get a little rowdy sometimes, but at the end of the day, you know, we're all faith, you know, leads us all. And
absolutely.
Admire one another, even though we don't show it on the court, right?
That's right, yeah.
Until the game's over.
Everybody's friends after the game.
That's right.
All right, Exon Catholic bringing the pressure. Myers has got it for the Eagles. Gets it over to Preston in the hall. Good job breaking the pressure this time. Gets it up. Myers, 3 balls up. Can't get it to fall. Hall with a nice rebound, but Potter and Doyle trap him. And Ted Hall says, we're not going to take a chance on turning this one over. They had him trapped there underneath the basket. So Ted Hall's like, you know what?
Protecting. That's a good timeout. Right. Speaking of timeouts right now, you got 1 for LCA left. You got 2 timeouts for Catholic. So Salzman keeping his 2. We'll see. He might need them with, we got 2.5 minutes left.
Yeah, a little over 2. So I got a feeling he'll be using at least one of them. Let's see. But
yeah,
they get a press turnover, a bucket. You know he'll do that.
I was going to comment on this floor. You know, it really brightens the place up in here and looks really, really nice.
Yeah, they've done a great job here updating this and new floor.
Yeah, it's
got the new turf field and football this year. LCA and joined the other schools here in town. So
I mentioned the athletic directors earlier. You know, Terry Johnson, I call him the mayor over here, because all this stuff has happened underneath his leadership. You know, all these different upgrades and things, and he's done one heck of a job over here.
Yes, Terry does a great job. Works incredibly hard, but a great man, and been a blessing to work with him the last 8 years, being the voice of LCA for football and basketball. Good shot there by Green, but can't get it to fall. Nice try to respond. They get it to Potter. He goes up and he dunks it. So it's down to three, 1:55 left in the game. Lexington Catholic bringing the pressure, and Hall tried to. Yep, probably should have just let that go, but hard not to, though. Good pressure there by Williams for Lexington Catholic. And Lexington Catholic looks to tie it with a three ball. Zaxton Howard is going to check back in. So for the Eagles, you've got Howard, you've got Martin, Hall, Green, and Preston. Catholic, you got Potter, Doyle, Sparks, Reinhart. And they drive baseline to Potter. Really good play there. It's down to one. Saxton Howard's got it. Pressured there by Doyle. Does a great job of breaking it. Gets it to Green, but he's in the corner. And he does a great job of trying to get out of the trap and able to use his quickness on the seven-footer Potter. And Potter gets called for the foul. And got a feeling this one might have to be won at the free throw line, William.
Yep. Could come down to that with 1:32 left to go in this ball game.
Green has got 5 points on the game.
LCA does need to get a man on Potter if they can, though, because the last few times down the court, he's dominated on the offense.
They do a good job driving baseline, and the help creates a gap there for him. But Green is an outstanding free throw shooter, 84% on the year, and he makes both of those. And that gives him 7 on the game and gets LCA's lead back up to 3. Almost threw it over Potter, which is hard to do, but Potter does a great job of getting it, but couldn't get his little jumper to fall. He's made most of them. He's got 24 to lead all scores for both teams, but this time the pass too tall for LCA, and fortunately Hall not 7 foot tall. He's 6'3", and great effort there, but just could not quite come up. That pass was a little too high there, the cross-court pass, so see if Kaplan can take advantage of the turnover. No, they'll definitely try to see if they can get into Potter. Been very successful the last few times down with that. On the block, he goes up, gets the ball stripped from him. I think that was Howard. Howard with the steal.
Yeah, Howard, Potter brought that ball down, waist level, and Howard there to make the easy strip.
Wow, got the jump ball there. They're letting them play. And Mr. Salzman's going to use one of those two timeouts that he has. So you have to be very strong with the ball here.
Both teams are in the bonus, too. So that's another factor coming down the stretch.
Well, I was looking before the game, free throw percentage-wise, LCA is a team shooting 69%. Lexington Catholic, 73%. Green's the guy you want on the free throw line if you're LCA shooting 84% from the free throw line.
Looks like Scott County and Bourbon are tied up right now, 37 all, 4:52 left to go in the third quarter. And then also Henry Clay is leading Sayre right now in the third quarter, 37-30.
Okay. Well, it is
the Perdochis are watching tonight, and they say they absolutely love the play-by-play. Greg Horn.
Well, we have a lot of fun, enjoy doing the games with you, William. So we've done a lot of basketball in the past, and hopefully maybe get to do some more this year.
I'm sure that they were talking about you. They hear me too much.
Nothing but love for the King of Stream. Well, let's see what Coach Salzman, the outstanding coach, Lex Catholic, draws up out of the timeout here. I got a feeling it's going to have a touch for Potter in some form or fashion. And he gets it there, spins up, and I believe that may be on Hall. If they do, that's going to be it for him, and that is going to be tough for LCA. He is their only inside presence, and Coach Ted Hall doesn't really like that call. And
Salzman sending in Clemens, and it looks like who else came in for them just now?
Apologize, I was looking towards the LCA bench. To Coach Ted Hall did not like that call, he's saying.
Yeah, 21.
21 back in, that's Williams.
Yeah, Williams.
The 6'4" junior. Potter's gonna go back to the free throw line where he's had an excellent night. I believe he's 5 for 5 there. He's got 24, he leads all scores, but for Hall, Tyler Hall, that's unfortunately gonna be it for him. He flees with 18, and Potter makes it again. Said a really nice free throw shooter for the Knights. Potter, 76%. And that's gonna go up after this game because he is, I believe, 7 of 7. So I'm gonna move that up a little bit. We've got a 2-point game with 35 seconds. And Saxton Howard trying to get open, used his elbow to.
Sam Clements took the charge right there.
So that's gonna be Howard's first or second foul now. I have one, that gives him two. So
that's a big turnover.
Checking in for LCA, Colt Cummins, 6'5 sophomore, and Connor Martin will get a breather. They need some size in there, so that's why they put in Cummins at 6'5. They get in to Potter, you know they're gonna try to get right back to him. Green trying to bot him there, but such a big, huge size mismatch. Doyle, 3-ball in the corner, it's off, but Doyle grabs it, gets the rebound. Catholic goes up by one. We've got 18 seconds left. LCA's got one timeout left. So far, Coach Hall not looking to use it, just gonna let him play through it. And
play it out.
Now he does call a timeout with 7.4 seconds, so.
Wow. We've seen this before in this rivalry, you know, it happens every now and then. But it's been a while for LCA over Catholic, I believe.
Yeah, with basketball, LCA had the upper hand at football for
they
the past
did.
2 years, and yeah. Catholic got it back this year. Convincing win.
Catholic in the new poll that came out today, too, they were ranked number 2 in the state.
Yes, sir. They definitely are playing.
If LCA wins this game, this student section, they're going to fill that court, I guarantee.
No doubt about it. You can beat the number 2 ranked team. Catholics won 13 in a row, as you said earlier, have not lost since November 28th on the road at North Laurel. So not a bad loss there by any stretch, but 13 in a row. And it's not like they played an easy schedule either, will you?
No, they've played some of Kentucky's best. And then, you know, of course, they went down to Florida too and won that whole tournament and played against some of the nation's best in that.
Two outstanding teams here, LCA 10-2. They've won 4 in a row, won that tournament in Carolina. So both teams have excellent basketball teams this year. But let's see what Coach Ted Hall, the outstanding coach for Lexington Christian Academy, has got dialed up in this timeout. You would think that Green's going to get a touch. He's their leading scorer. But I'll tell you, Saxton Howard, just a sophomore. But that kid, he has a lot of confidence, plays with a lot of confidence. So I believe that either Green or Howard will be taking this last shot. And Green's got into a crossover dribble. Wow, it's got to be a block foul, and it is. Green drives to the bucket. And
he's going to get the bonus with 2.5 here. He's going to get a 1 and a bonus shot if he hits that one.
Green's got 7 on the night, and he is the leading scorer. He's an 84% free throw shooter. He's 2 for 2 from the line going into this attempt here. But obviously, William, it's a little bit different when there's 2.5 seconds left on the clock. And it's a 1-point game.
Can you imagine being at the free throw line against the number 2 team in the state? Your biggest rivalry, and you got an opportunity here to give your team the lead. We got to tie it first, but then give your team the lead, possibly.
We got a wet spot there on the floor, so Green wisely steps back off the free throw line.
You know, the sixth man for Lexington Catholic and the sixth man for LCA tonight, talking about the student sections, they have been big time.
Yeah, they both are packed out and both really into the games. It makes high school sports great. So Green's got the first one here of the bonus. It's up.
And oh, did not hit.
Not able to get it. And Potter gets the rebound. Lexington Catholic with an unbelievable comeback win as LCA's had an 18-0 lead and just unfortunately could not hold on there. And feel really bad for the young man Green. He's an outstanding player. And man, it looked like it was good. It came in and then it went down. So it was tough. I thought it was going to be in for Green, but just could not get it to stay down. And Lexington Catholic, they're the number two ranked team in the country. I mean, the state for a reason, William.
They could be, and you never know. Something tells me that goes to like the big teams out of Chicago or the Brawny team out in California or something.
Right, yep, one of those preps teams.
Yeah.
But, wow, what a game.
But nonetheless, this was a great game. LCA certainly came out and gave them the best shot.
Well, there's no doubt they did. Potter leads the way for Lexington Catholic with 27 points. So
Salzman came over here and told the student section to pick up all their trash that they had just thrown out on the court. I just seen that. So that's a positive thing there for Coach Salzman to do.
Absolutely. It's both teams, like I said, packed out on both sides here. So
Salzman and Coach Hall, they got a lot of respect for one another. No doubt about it.
Two great coaches there, and we got a great basketball game, 10-2 and 13-1, and that's the result that you would expect that we would have, and we got it. So knew that Lexington Catholic would make a run after being down 18-0 at the beginning of the game, and they were down at halftime by 18, also 42-24. They just kept chipping away at it, and at the end there, held on. So that's what when you've got a special team and a winning team, that's what you do, right, William?
That's totally what you do. You hit it right on the head. Thank you. Here's the box score.
All right, let's look at some final stats here. We'll look at first for Lexington Catholic. You got Sam Clements with two, Tyler Doyle with 15 points and three right rebounds. Connor Doyle, 27 points and five rebounds. Just a really impressive night, 11 of 18 from the field. 6 of 7 at the free throw line. I missed one, I guess, earlier. He had missed the one there, but wow, what a night for Reese Potter, man.
Yeah, he was big time, and truly the difference. You know, Doyle kind of got him started a little bit, and then Potter, I mean, throughout the game, he just kept adding up his numbers.
John Reinhart had 10 points. And then Hudson Sparks, their second leading scorer, did a lot of nice things that, you know, just don't show up in the score box, but only had two tonight, but got a lot of deflections and was great in defense with that. Brody Turner did a good job on the defensive side. He played but did not score. Williams had a really nice game for Lexington Catholic. He had 8 points and five rebounds. And Miller Williams had 2 points for the Eagles, I'm sorry, for the Knights, 67 points. For LCA, Hayes Preston had 2 points and four rebounds. Colt Cummins had 5 points and one rebound. Anderson Green had 10 points and six rebounds. Tyler Hall led the way for LCA with 18 points and seven rebounds. The senior having his usual outstanding game. Saxton Howard, 12 points. And Connor Martin had 11. Braden Myrish had 8. And that's how LCA got their 66 points. Lexington Catholic only shot 29% in the first half, William, but we knew that wasn't going to last. They shot 47% for the game. They shot 55% in the second half, so knew the Catholic would respond. LCA for the game shot 53%. So both teams, both really nice offensive teams, and, man, it was a hard-played game.
Yeah, definitely. And you look over here, the difference for Lexington Catholic was that third quarter. 25-11. LCA in that first quarter was 23-8. That's your difference right there.
Yep, you're right.
First quarter versus third quarter.
Yep, that's when Catholic made the dent there. Lexington Catholic 14 points out of that 18-point deficit. And yet LCA had a chance to win it there. Potter made the putback there with about 12 seconds left. LCA came down, got a timeout with 7 seconds, and Green got a good drive and just unfortunately couldn't get the front end of that bonus to fall, but he's just a sophomore. You know that he is going to bounce back from that. I don't know, man. This is what we expected in the Holy War. Great game tonight, William.
Yeah, no, they will play again probably a couple more times this season. So, you know, it's hard to beat a team three times. You know that.
Absolutely. Well, just a great, great high school game. We're so glad that you joined us. I already had some challenges there in the first half, but, hey, the second half was the best half to watch, and so glad that you watched it with us. Any final thoughts there, William?
I just appreciate you letting me crash your party tonight, and, you know, like I said, you know, I woke up this morning. I was like, man, we're gonna get that game on somehow, some way. And you know, I just appreciate you being here and being you, man.
Oh man, but it's always an honor to work with you, brother. Appreciate your love for high school.
Followed you all summer, by the way. I was like, man, Greg's all over the place. Greg's all over the place.
I was fortunate, hadn't done any vacations for 3 years, and God bless me, I got to do two this year. One of them was Israel, so very, very thankful. Part of it was work, but part of it was honestly fun too. And feel very, very fortunate, and you got to go to the Holy Land. We had the Holy War here tonight, but appreciate you, William, and all that PrepSpin does for high school athletics, man. What a blessing. You got people from Nebraska watching tonight and seeing family and friends. That's a blessing, man.
Yeah, that is. That's, you know, and there's, I mean, they're all over the place, man. You got alumni tuning into this game, and these games are always some of our biggest watch games that there is, you know, and, you know, it never gets old. It's always fun to watch, and you know, just praise the Lord that we get to do them, Greg.
Absolutely, man. It's a privilege and an honor. So thank you so much for all that you do for high school athletics and the help that you've given me. You provided the headsets that I'm using now that I get to use for radio. You're a very generous guy. So I know most people know that, but William does a lot of things that people don't know, like blessing me. He saw I had such a bad set of headsets that I was using with the radio. And a couple years ago, he said, brother, I got you a gift. And he opened up his box of brand new headsets. So thank you, man, for your investment in my broadcasting. I appreciate you, man.
Anytime, brother. I love you just like my own brother. So.
All right. Well, for William Warfield, I'm Greg Horton. Thanks for joining us here tonight on PrepSpin. Your final score in the Holy War, Lexington Catholic 67, Lexington Christian Academy 66. Thanks for watching. Well, make sure you don't miss that big game Saturday, North Laurel and Lyon County. Is that right? What time is that one?
We got doubleheader Saturday. We got, like you said, North Laurel and Lyon County. It's going to be at 6. I'm sorry, that game's going to be at 7 p.m. And then Lexington Catholic takes on Mel before that game.
Oh, wow.
That we'll have as well. So a doubleheader coming on Saturday.
What a matchup. Great high school basketball.
And starting next week, we're just kind of, you know, regular routine, finally.
I was going to say, you don't know what that is, do you? All right. Well, thanks for joining us tonight. For William Warfield, I'm Greg Horn. Good night.